Bamboo reinforced concrete is an ill-considered concept. Treatments intended to enhance the durability and/or bond to concrete are labor-intensive, costly, and often utilize materials of known toxicity. They have little practical value. In order to illustrate the behavior of bamboo reinforced concrete, we'll demonstrate four comparable beams, each 200 millimeters deep, 150 millimeters wide. Beam U is plain unreinforced concrete. Beam S is steel reinforced concrete having a reinforcement ratio of 1.5%, typical of an under reinforced concrete beam. Beam F, BF, is bamboo reinforced concrete having a reinforcement ratio of just over 2% and is designed to have the same strength of reinforcement as beam S. Beam E is also bamboo reinforced concrete having a reinforcement ratio exceeding 5%, designed to have the same stiffness of reinforcement as beam S. Each beam is tested in simple flexure over a span of 2160 millimeters. The tests are shown here. Beam U is not shown, it's unreinforced, fails in a brittle manner very rapidly. The considerable ductility and evidence of beam S is very clear in the image on the upper right. Looking at the data from these tests, initial cracking of each beam is very similar, just under 10 kilonewtons applied load. The peak loads, on the other hand, are very different. The bamboo reinforced concrete beams barely reach their cracking loads, whereas the steel reinforced concrete beam, as one expects, achieves a considerably higher load and considerably greater displacement. Looking at the energy absorbed by each of these tests, the dominance of the steel beam, the steel reinforced concrete beam, is clearly in evidence, absorbing an order of magnitude greater energy than the other tests. Looking in detail at the applied load versus deflection curves and zooming in on the initial portion of those curves to illustrate the initial cracking, we see that there is no expected change in cracking capacity of these girders. Reinforcement has little impact on the initial cracking loads. The post-cracking behavior, however, is significantly different. Once cracked, the reinforcement is required to carry the tension crossing that crack. In the case of steel reinforced concrete, the assumption of perfect bond allows the capacity to continue to increase with very little loss of stiffness until yield of the steel, and eventually we see a very long ductile plateau. In the case of bamboo reinforced concrete, we see rather precipitous drops in capacity. The capacity does pick up a little bit once the bamboo is engaged. However, the capacity really shows very little reserve over the cracking loads of these beams. So regardless of whether designed for equivalent strength or stiffness, the bamboo reinforced concrete beams exhibited precipitous loss in capacity upon cracking and were barely able to recover their initial cracking loads. Bamboo reinforced concrete must be designed to remain uncracked.